Aloha! Welcome to your online College of Natural Sciences orientation. This orientation was designed just for students who will be entering the College of Natural Sciences at the University of Hawaii at Manoa. This module is for incoming freshmen only. If you are not a freshman, ACE registration is not an option for you. So please skip this module and move on to Module 5.2, GPS registration. But if you are an incoming freshman, stick around to see if ACE Learning Communities are right for you. ACE Learning Communities are available to incoming Manoa students in the fall semester only. The benefits of ACE are that you'll be clustered together with about 15 other students with similar interests as you. You will take all of your ACE cluster classes together, including a one-credit seminar course led by an upperclassman called CAS 110, Access to College Community. This makes forming study groups and support networks with your peers very easy. The main drawback to the ACE program is that these clusters are an all-or-nothing deal. If you have already earned credit for any of the cluster courses through AP, IB, CLEP, or dual enrollment credits, or if there is a course in the cluster that you just don't want to take, then you should not register through ACE. Nearly every major in the College of Natural Sciences has a cluster that is recommended for them. We have developed a table for you to reference, which you can access from our online orientation website. To get there, you'll go to Students and Alumni, Incoming Students, Online Orientation. From there, you'll scroll down to the Module 5.1 section, and you will see the link to the ACE cluster table for CNS majors. This table has links for everything that you'll need to see regarding ACE clusters. At the very top of the document, there is a link to the general ACE cluster webpage. From here, you can scroll down and see a list of the general cluster types. If you go back to the table, you'll see that each major has a hyperlink to a cluster that is meant to best fit that major. For example, we can look at the Exploratory STEM cluster, which is here in the Exploratory Cluster section, right here. Most of these clusters will require you to take placement exams before you can register. You'll notice that this cluster requires you to take Chemistry 161 in lab. You can't enroll in that class unless you've taken the placement exam and placed into that class. You'll also notice that this says that you'll need to enroll in a math course and that the course you'll sign up for will be based on a placement exam. Knowing which clusters and courses to register for will definitely require you to have either completed the chemistry and mathematics placement exams, as required by your major, or have earned credits for Chemistry 131, Chemistry 151, Math 134, or Math 140. So if you've not taken your placement exams yet, you'll go back to the placement exam modules, watch those videos, and complete the exams to obtain your scores. Once that's done, come back to this video to proceed with ACE registration. Okay, so now that you have your placement exam scores in hand and you know exactly which chemistry and math courses to sign up for, we can proceed with ACE registration. The Exploratory STEM cluster only gives you one chemistry option, but let's take a look at some of those life sciences options. You'll see that the pre-health and life science clusters have Chemistry 161 and lab in them, but if we scroll down to the preparatory health and life science cluster, then this includes preparation for general chemistry. So if you've placed into that course, then this is the specific cluster that you should register for. The same thing goes for the biology and marine biology clusters available just a little bit below, where there is one cluster with Chemistry 161 in lab and another one with Chemistry 131. So the cluster that you will select will heavily depend upon the results of your chemistry placement exam. In addition to that, many of these clusters have an added math course that you're required to take, and you won't know which math class to sign up for until you've completed that placement exam. In the event that you do not place into Chemistry 131, 161, or 171, then you will need to register through STAR instead of ACE. You can contact your academic advisor for assistance in crafting a schedule to best fit your needs. When you're ready to actually register for your cluster, you'll want to make sure that you're following the steps listed at the top of the webpage. First, you'll need to select which learning community you want to sign up for. Next, you will actually register for that learning community. Third, once you've registered for that learning community, you need to wait 48 hours to add your elective courses through STAR. These are like your guided electives that you can see down here. Fourth, you will then have to complete the new student checklist, which is available here through the ACE website and also on our student timelines. And after that, you will be good to go and ready to start for the fall. So we're going to show you what registration for the ACE cluster looks like right now. When you click there, you will make sure to select ACE Learning Communities as your registration option. And that will take you to a login screen that looks like this. At the top of the page, you'll log in with your UH username and password. Once you've logged in, it will take you to the Learning Communities registration portal. If you remember which cluster number you selected from before, then you're going to look for that cluster on this page right now. I'm a biochemistry major who placed into Chemistry 161 in lab and Math 140. So with that in mind, I'm going to use those placement exam results to help me select my cluster. I do know that I want to sign up for one of those life sciences clusters. I just haven't decided which one yet. So I'm going to scroll down until I find the Pre-Health and Life Sciences Learning Communities. And I was actually reading some about the C phages program, and that sounded really interesting to me. Because between these two, only one of them is the Chemistry 161 cluster. I'm going to select that as my option. And then after that, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom of the page, read this very important information. And once I'm done reading it, I will acknowledge the statement and submit my registration. And that's it. That's how you register for your ACE Learning Community. Just do remember that at the end of this, I need to wait for 48 hours, and after that I can add my two guided electives, which are going to be English 100 and the Math 140 class that I placed into. However, we're not completely done yet. After registering for your ACE cluster, you should log in to STAR. To log into STAR, go to MyUH Services and then click on the STAR tile. We need you to check your account to ensure the following. 1. You can see your placement exam results or transfer credits for the aforementioned chemistry and mathematics courses. And 2. Your registration holds have been taken care of or will be taken care of soon. After you log into STAR, go to the GPS registration tab if you aren't automatically taken there. To view your placement exam results, you can click on the test scores link on the right-hand sidebar. To view your holds, check to see if you can see a red View Holds button from the top left of the page. If you're counting on transfer credits to get you into chemistry or mathematics, you should be able to see those from the GPS registration tab as well by scrolling up to the semester when those credits were taken. And that's all, folks. Now that you know how ACE registration works, it's time to take the mini quiz.